welcome to Cheap Joe's Art Stuff. My name is Julie, and I'm here to impart some knowledge to you today via a two-minute art tip. And today's tip comes from a young friend of mine, my daughter and all of her friends who are soon going off to college. We had planned a really nice lake day as one final hurrah before all of them venture out into their new lives and stuff like that. So kind of a bittersweet day. One of my daughter's friends is a very accomplished artist named Kata. Kata does really skillfully executed drawings and watercolor portraits, and got some examples here. Many of them are very small, you can see, but very, very well done and stuff like this. You know, she was saying, oh, I love art, but I finished something and, you know, I look at it and I'm happy with it for about an hour, you know, and then not so much, and I start picking it apart and stuff like that, and that feeling goes away. And I was thinking, oh, that's that's terrible, but how surprisingly universal that feeling is. She's a young person, she's, you know, just turned 18. Thing that I was taking from that is that, you know, with all of her skill set and all of her abilities, you know, she feels like that, just like anybody feels like that. And it really is kind of universal. The interesting thing about that feeling, though, is that in some ways, for many people, that like sinking feeling is also what keeps people working. You know, because if you capitalize on that feeling, you know, whether it hits you in an hour or whether it hits you in a couple of days or whether it hits you in a few months after looking at something that you finished, is that if you make the most of those thoughts and kind of examine what you've done, what is it that you like about this? What is it that you were intending to do that you feel like you didn't accomplish? What would you change about it if you got to back up in time and then start over and do things differently? And you may find that it's helpful when you get those feelings to flip the piece over and put a post-it note on it and like jot those thoughts down. Because if it's the kind that's just going to go in a drawer for later, or you don't feel like this is good enough to frame at this point, it's a good idea to kind of make some mental notes about that piece and what that feeling brings to you, because those kind of notes and references can be helpful for your next journey out there. So whether, you know, you're happy with things for an hour or 10 minutes or before you even put the last lick of paint on there, you're already feeling defeated. Make the most of that feeling and understand that everybody feels that way. But use it as some fuel for the next time. And, capitalize on those thoughts and feelings to turn it into positive energy. And thank you for watching, and we hope that you enjoyed.